10:13. Purposes of a quorum, Commissioner Sanchez and myself, Commissioner Sanchez, are here at the CCU office appearing via GoToMeeting as Chairman Joey Duñez and Commissioner Mike Limchaco. Commissioner Peter Juan Martinez is off island and not available. So we do have a quorum. We call the meeting to order. There are no public comments noted, so therefore, we're going to go ahead and start with Mr. John Beneventi on item number three. Mr. Beneventi?
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Resolution number 2022-1. Here, this is willing to give approval of extending the cameras warning for the homeless management contract on the EMC for Taiwan Electric and Mechanical Services, as better known as PEMEX, no? Now, the contract actually is came into place for a three-year with two option and one-year period beginning in September 2023. However, of course, the base rate is expiring September 30th of this year, in the next few months. We all know Gabus Power Plant is not slated for retirement until after the Upudo Power Plant is completed period. And furthermore, we could now see that as a result of the typhoon Mahua, there will be an extension as to the commissioning of that power plant. And so therefore, I'd like to also know that furthermore, PEMEX had written to me in April about their intent to terminate the EMC contract after September 30th and not go for the option years. And so, of course, it's imperative in my opinion that we have PEMEX continue, most especially for the next 2 years. Most especially because it'd be difficult to get anyone to get the good in place, and furthermore, the Gabus warning to power plants are certainly the last stage of the. And a lot of work is needed to keep it going, no? Therefore, we did negotiate, and as a result, they have given our ACMO. Negotiated a contract with PEMEX for the extension of the EMC contract beginning from October 1st of this year to October, September 30th, 2025. And that gives us that we do from the. If it's the last few months, I think either we can extend it or we can run it ourselves, not for the next 2 years. So therefore, they did require, because again, labor charges have gone up, scenarios where they need additional people in the plant. So then the price for the 2-year extension actually increased. Therefore, what we're looking now is the. Fixed management fee, the annual fee for now from 27 million to 8 million for the last 2 years of the extension, no? And so that's about a 400,000 or so per year increase of the thing, which we don't believe is unreasonable for the amount of work that has to be done with Gabus 1 and 2. And furthermore, they're adding another 2 engineers to the facility because of the age of the plan and all of that. So so that's the resolution I would like to ask the commission to approve for us. And again, we'll have to go to the PUC. But certainly, not having the PMC on board is really not an option that we would like to have, no?
Yeah. Mr. Chairman, I move to approve resolution FY2023-21 relative to the approval of the extension of Gabus 1 and 2 Power Plant PMC with PEMEX.
Second.
Thank you very much, Chairman Duñez. All right. That was Commissioner Chaco, right?
Yes.
Okay, any discussion?
John, listening to you, it's $4 million is both the management and the O&M, not just the, I think, as you were reading it, it's the management. It's actually the combination of both management and the And the out-of-pocket to run the district,
no, no.
Right?
It's 8 million.
No, it's eight.
It's 4 plus 4 rather than. I'm sorry. All I was correcting was you said the management fee was 4 million. It's the management fee plus the O&M was 4 million, and the next year's 4 million. That's how you get 8 million. Right? 2.6 plus 1.3, 2.7 plus 1.3, 4 plus 4 is 8.
Yeah, that's correct.
Yeah, that's all. Okay.
Any other discussion, members?
Yes. No further discussion.
Commissioner Johnson?
No questions.
All right.
No questions.
Our last rule.
I'll call for the vote on resolution 2321. All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
All right.
Aye.
Thank you very much. Okay.
Thank you, Commissioner.
All right. Next item on the agenda is the executive session.
You need a motion?
Yeah, I need a motion, Mr.
Chairman, I move that we go into executive session to discuss litigation matters.
All right.
We're not streaming an executive session, though.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, so you have to be talking to them while you're on the ring.
Make sure we're not streaming before you vote.
Yeah, because you're... Yeah, can you just...
go-to meeting is... You need a different go-to meeting? For the
go-to meeting is different, sir. It's only...
Okay, Commissioner Mjako?
Yeah, I'm here.
Okay, all right. We are now back in regular session. Mr. Bedalia?
So, thank you, Mr. Chair. We're proposing ratification number 01-FY2023 relative to authorizing the ratification of a settlement agreement and release for our litigation on the lawsuit that was discussed in the executive session.
Okay. No, no, you need to make the...
I'm sorry. I move that we ratify resolution 01-FY2023 relative to authorizing the ratification of a settlement agreement and release.
A second.
Okay. Any further discussion?
No.
Chairman Duenas? Chairman Mjako?
No.
Okay, I will call for the vote, and this will be a roll call. Chairman Duenas?
Aye.
Commissioner Mjako?
Aye.
Commissioner Sanchez?
Aye.
Commissioner Santos, aye. I will note for the record, Commissioner Martinez is absent and will not be able to vote. Okay, so the vote is 4-0. This ratification has now passed. A call for a motion to adjourn this meeting.
Move to adjourn, Mr. Chairman.
So moved. Thank you very much, Chairman Duenas and Commissioner Mjako.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Ready?
Good job.
Bye.
Thank you, Miguel.
Good job.
You have to sign.